clap it up for this MC. Came a long way, Heather B, to be with us today.
I love it.
Came a long way to be with us today. Young lady by way of Portland, Oregon, citizens, give her a big round of applause. She's been planting her seeds.
Yes, sir.
Spitting these bars on multiple freestyles. I had to do the research myself to make sure she was consistent with it, if I may. If I may, one of her projects that came out that I rewound, and I rewound it, have the B. I wasn't streaming it. I rewound it over and over again because a good friend of mine told me she had bars. And so I went down that twisty, windy, dark hole of freestyles and listening to songs and really getting into our next artist because I wanted to hear it for myself. And it's something about Oregon, being from the West Coast. You know, I used to go up to Portland, Oregon, Eugene, Oregon, actually, to run track.
Let's go Ducks.
Yeah, yes, exactly. So I used to run track up there a lot. And then as I got older and got into hip-hop, got into the music scene, we used to visit Oregon a lot, King Tech and I. We used to visit Seattle as well. I believe there was an artist by the name of Immaculate.
Oh, yes.
Immaculate from that region of the area. That's your boy? You know Immaculate?
Yeah, Immaculate.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's on the Thesis record.
He's on the Thesis record. Yeah. That's right. Okay. Did you know him prior to that?
Yeah. No, he's legend.
He's legend?
Battle legend. Yeah, in Portland, he's Princess Diana.
Princess Diana. The thing is about that scene, you have a lot of organic music that comes out. People usually know the history. They study the legacies. And so when you hear artists from there, they're rhyming for different reasons.
Yeah.
And when I listen to you, I hear you rhyming for reasons. Mm. You know, you sound like someone who studied the craft.
Yeah.
You didn't seem like somebody who just jumped behind a pen and said, I want to rap for the sake of rapping.
Right.
You couldn't be that with all of those intricate, complex patterns that you have in between those bars.
Yeah,
so I want to say welcome to the show.
Thank you.
She's here. She got a new single and new music video called Ja Morant.
Yeah.
You can ask her what that means. It's pretty funny. It's pretty damn funny. It clicked to me later, too. That's the ironic thing about it. Oh, Ja Morant. But she's done a lot, man, and I'm glad to have her here. That was a roll call we just played.
Yeah.
And when I heard that song, I heard her catch a nice flow, and I said, yeah, this is the one I want to start off this conversation with. Please welcome the one and only Wynne to the show.
Wynne.
Welcome.
It's an honor, for real.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You grew up watching us?
Oh, yeah, I did.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
What used to watch us?
I watch all the YouTube freestyles. So, like, first one comes to my mind is King Los. Like,
yeah, man.
I mean, just, you're such a legend. And growing up as, like, someone who really takes the craft seriously as, like, an MC, Sway is, like, the holy grail. Like, I told my mom, like, I'm going to the Olympic trials. Like, I'm out here. So
I like your metaphors.
Yeah. Yeah. Very strong. Yeah, but I'm not a rapper.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's dope to be here. It's really an honor. Like, you're such a legend, and had to be yourself as well.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And Tracy is growing to become a legend.
Hey, you already know. I can feel it.
Yeah, you feel it. And Mike Muse is legend too.
Yes,
you
can, let's go.
And torch.
Yes, sir.
All right.
The Olympic torch.
The Olympic torch.
Let them know.
The Olympic torch. It's good to have you here, and it's ironic that you're sitting here at Shade 4-5 because for so long, people thought you was Eminem's daughter.
Right. I know.
So, what does that feel? Do you feel at home right now?
Oh yeah, yes. My dad's radio station.
Right.
Well, how did that get started, though?
You know, so I had a line in there where I said, because in Portland, obviously, we get a lot of clouds, we get a lot of hail, we get a lot of rain. So I said, it's hailing in Portland. I guess I'm the daughter of Shady. I was doing a cipher out there, and somebody just was clever and took it, I guess, wanted to go viral and was like, oh, this is Haley. This is Eminem's daughter. So that just blew up. It was all over Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, like anywhere you can imagine. Like, I had some of my favorite rappers hitting people from my team who didn't know that I worked with them. Like, yo, you see, this is Eminem's daughter? like some like legends, mm-hmm. and I just had to be like, damn, like my name's Wynne. I'm actually not related to Eminem, but that's cool. I mean, he's a legend, so
yeah.
So it's a compliment for sure.
Yo, Marshall, call us up real quick, man. Yeah. Let's make sure she's not lying to us.
Let's set it straight. Yeah.
Let's set it straight.
Yeah.
You grew up studying who?
It was a lot of Lupe Fiasco, a lot of mm-hmm. Jay-Z, a lot of like T.I., honestly, a lot of Eminem. I listened to a lot of Alicia Keys. There was Nas in there, Lil Wayne, a lot of Lil Wayne, some Jeezy, 50 Cent. It was a lot of early 2000s stuff for me. Yeah.
Were you memorizing the songs? Or?
Oh my gosh, yeah. I was laying in my bed. My brother used to, we shared a wall, so my brother used to like bang on my wall because I would just be rapping. I'd have my Skullcandy headphones on and be laying in my bed. And I would just be like top of my lungs rapping all the lyrics to all these things. And that was like from when I was 9 to 12. And then when I was 12, that's when I really started to like write. I actually started writing remixes before I was 12, but it was like to Soul Survivor. You know, it was like, the most random shit. So yeah.
That's
once
interesting.
I was 12, I started writing.
Obviously, we have so many conversations about like representation, diversity, mm-hmm. inclusion, and how important it is to see someone doing what you want to do that looks like you.
Totally.
And so like, I'm thinking about a young Wynne, and I'm like, yeah. It never bothered you that you didn't really see a white female rapper killing it. Because you're naming all of these black, you know.
Yeah, well, I knew that wasn't the lane, you know, like it was just clear to me that since the beginning, I've always taken this as like, this is not my culture. I partake in this and I'm a guest. And so I never expected to see a white woman doing it. But most of my influences when I was growing up, as I listed, they were all mostly men. So it took me a while to kind of grow into my own voice because mm-hmm. I was always trying to sound more aggressive and trying to sound more like, you know, hard. But it's like at the end of the day, my voice is soft and sultry. And so it did take a while to like really embrace that, you know. And
to build your confidence as well.
Oh, yeah, totally. Mm-hmm. Totally. Yeah.
I'm curious as to what your mama said, because I remember coming home and saying I was going to be a rapper, but at least she's like, okay, there's Queen Latifah. Like, yeah, there's people out there.
Right,
but shit, I know you was like, you told your mom you was coming to Sway. Yeah. I mean,
man, my family's mad supportive. Like,
that's dope.
I grew up in a family where, like, whatever I wanted to do, my parents wanted to support me. They wanted me to be who I was. And you know, when I was 12 and I was like, I'm gonna grow up and be a rapper, they were like, okay, you know, so I definitely had the plan B conversations with my dad, but I'm something about me, I'm a Taurus, I'm hard headed. You're not gonna convince me of shit. I've never had a plan B in my life. I was just like, I know this is gonna work, like mm-hmm. I know I'm ill. And so, you know, eventually they came around. I remember talking to my dad my first year. I went to University of Oregon, uh-huh. and I remember talking to him, and at first I didn't wanna go to college because I was like, none of my idols really went except for J. Cole. And I was like, I just don't need to do that. And he was like, look, totally understand. You're going to make the decision you want to make. But, like, just not think it would be good for you. Ultimately made the decision to go, which was one of the best decisions I made. I met a lot of great people there. Mm-hmm. I played in a band. Like, people to this day still on my team. Shout out Ty over there.
Oh, dope.
But he hit me after things started to kind of move. I started to have these viral freestyles go. And he hit me and was like, yo, like, I understand if you want to, like, pull out of school and just do this. And shout out to my team. They were mad patient as I was like, no, I wanna finish and get my degree. So that was 2019, I graduated, and then pandemic hit shortly after.
Come on, man. You graduated. 2019,
and
right?
Shout out to supportive parents.
Yeah. Seriously, yeah. Shout out to my parents.
Right before the pandemic.
Yeah.
Ooh. Yeah. And so the pandemic for all of us was just a useful tool to really ground ourselves and figure out what's next, right?
Absolutely.
How did you utilize that time?
That's a great question. If I may dropped in the end of 2019. I then went on a sold out tour with Earth Gang and Mick Jenkins and
Mick Jenkins, salute to Mick Jenkins and Earth Gang. Yeah,
man, it was a great tour. I can't speak highly enough about all those guys. They were perfect for my first tour. I definitely got spoiled. We got back 3 days before the pandemic hit, so we were lucky to finish it. But it was definitely like running 100 miles per hour into a brick wall. So I really kind of locked in. Me and Ty was like, you know, no one can go anywhere. So it's like, you're in the room, you got a pair of speakers, you got a mic, and you got a pair of headphones. And like, before the pandemic hit, I knew I was going to be like, to me, I'm trying to be like one of the goats of my generation.
Okay.
So I know I want to be a rap star. I know I want to be up there. I want to be respected as a lyricist, but I don't feel that way yet. Like, okay. I know that I have room to grow. I was really young. I was 22. I'm 26 now. So we used those 2 or 3 years to just kind of throw paint at the wall, do a lot of, like I said, vocal production, mm-hmm. kind of like get the flows down, learn how to write hooks, like learn how to do melodies. Because like I said, I came up in the cypher world. So, you know, there's that running joke that people who battle rap or who do cypher rap songs. Can't write songs.
Right. Write songs.
And that was me. So.
That's not a joke.
No. I was gonna say. I lived it. Like, it took years for me to figure out how to write a hook. And it's still something that I'm trying to sharpen in my tool belt. But that was a new challenge for me. I think people think it's really hard to write a mainstream record or to write or people think it's easy to write something like that. And to me, that was a totally different skill that I had just never, you know, wanted to work on. So that was a lot of fun for me. It was a challenge. Like, I think I came a long way. And also, like, I was going through my early 20s. It was my first year out of college. So it was like I was getting out of a toxic relationship, and I was like just learning about myself, like in the midst of kind of global catastrophe. So
that was a hard time to be breaking up out of a relationship. What was going on with quarantine?
Man,
you know, you worried about your career. You trying to find your voice. Did you find your thread? What is it that Wynne, what does Wynne want the world to know?
Yeah, I want people to first and foremost, like, respect me for my lyricism. I think I spent a long time, like, you know, perfecting my pen and really taking the craft seriously. So that's something when people look back on me in 10, 20 years, that's one of the first things I want them to say. And, you know, I feel like I can help kind of like bring some of that lyricism back into the mainstream, because I think that's, you know, that's just hasn't been a focus, and it's still out there, but that's something for me that makes now writing like more mainstream records, if you would say, fun, because I still have all that wordplay in there, like John Morant, like it's still, that wordplay to me has always been one of my most favorites. Like, that's why I reference Wayne specifically, is like, or even Jay-Z, like being able to listen to records a year or 2 years after I heard him and be like, oh, I just caught this
just
line.
Just caught that line, right?
And that's how I want people to feel about my music.
Okay, let's do this. Let's play that Ja Morant.
Mm-hmm. Let's do it.
Yes. Ja Morant, but you don't spell it like he spells his name.
No, I don't.
Can you talk about the way you spell it?
Yeah, I spell it with a W.
J-A-W Morant. Ja Morant.
That's a little preview into the metaphor.
It. Yeah.
Say it again for the people in the back.
I get it. Ja Morant. Yo, I'm going to tell you, I was baffled by that. Why did she call this shit Ja Morant? And it was a line. I can't think of the line you said that just.
There's probably a couple of
lines.
Yeah.
Something about, yo, that shit can't be cracking up the whole time. I almost called you. Rob Markman's here too, by the way. Rob Markman.
Shout out to Rob.
From Genius is here. You know, when Rob used to, he's still a member of the show. He just never came back once he got his job at Genius.
You know what?
You know,
I'm dead.
Used to do the Rob Report. You ever hear that?
Yeah.
That's where it all started, man. Yeah. You can't even
legend.
Can't even get lunch from this guy no more. Did he tell you about our history at all?
Not totally. I'm familiar.
You're
for
familiar
sure.
with it? Okay,
yeah.
that's my brother right there, man. He helped me look good for years.
Yeah, some MTV shit.
Yeah, absolutely, man. I helped him with nothing. I'm just a bully to Rob Markman, so it's now I'm joking. Ja Morant, this is it, man. Wynne is here. Get to know a real MC. Okay, citizens, 888-742-3345. Sway in the morning, Shade 45. Got the B, Tracy G, Mike Muse is in the building. Torch, DB. Mike, you wanna say anything to Wynne?
Yeah, I'm just wondering, like, what is, like, I'm always interested in a writer's POV. Right.
Yeah.
And so since you were a battle rapper, you weren't writing.
Yeah.
I'm just curious, like, what are you drawing upon? Like, what's your point of view?
Definitely just life experience. I mean, I've always been writing songs. So, like, even when I wasn't, like, writing for cyphers, I was still writing hooks. They just weren't good. So it's always been, you know, from a place of emotion, things I'm experiencing, like, and experience in the sense of, like, my POV, and experience in the sense of, like, things that I want to feel when I'm experiencing those things. Mm-hmm. So, like, a lot of the inspiration for Ja Morant was like, you know, I'm getting ready to go out with my girls, with my friends, and I don't have a record in my catalog that I can, like, really, like, turn up to. So that was a big motivation for me, something that was honestly a challenge for me to check off my list.
What does a practice session look like for you when you're trying to tighten up your hooks. You said that's something in your toolkit you really want to sharpen and polish.
Definitely.
Take us through that a bit.
Yeah, I mean, it's honestly just throwing a bunch of darts at the wall, trying to hit the bullseye. It's like I'm writing more songs, and I work a lot with Ty Mai, who's my engineer, but also just like my right-hand man. We do everything together, and he's really good about, I don't trust anyone else to record my vocals. Like, he gives me a lot of feedback, and you know, he'll I can tell when he doesn't feel like something's right, because he won't freak out.
Right.
He's a really excitable guy. So if he's sitting there and he's just like, that was cool, I'll be like, okay, that wasn't it. Like, I got to come with something harder. So yeah, I mean, I had 3 years to just kind of sit there. And like, if I have a hook that I'm intentional with my words to not, like, you know, I don't want to make the hooks too wordy. I want to keep them kind of simple. I don't want to throw, like, I don't want to have a super high unique word percentage in my hook, because it's got to be graspable for the listener. So yeah, it's just a feeling. Like, does it rock? Can you play it out of the speakers? Like, does Ty fuck with it?
I can see why the lyricist, like, your word choice is really interesting. You're talking about ratios.
Yeah. Right. She put a formula next to it, right?
I mean, she got a whole theory, like, you know. I think that's it.
Yeah.
I was going to say, do you feel like school came in handy in terms of, like, being a wordsmith?
I think so, but I'm one of those people who, like, I'm a word brain. I'm not a math brain. I can count a 16 and that's about it. Like, I've always leaned towards words in English class, and I was lucky to have English teachers who, like, really embraced that part of me and allowed me to, like once I was in seventh grade, actually, my English teacher, shout out to Mrs. Shank, she was the only person who I told that I rapped, because I was, like, embarrassed, you know, like, I'm living in the suburbs, like, you know, my Beats headphones on and my Air Force Ones, like, man, like, this is crazy. So I told her, and she would let me, like, turn in raps instead of, like, essays for things.
Wow.
Oh,
so,
shit. Miss Shank?
Yeah,
Miss Shank?
Shout out to Miss Shank, yeah, and just teachers in general, we had poetry lessons, and they would always just kind of let me do my thing, so I was super lucky, yeah.
You know, so it's really interesting, and when we had a previous guest, Samuel L. Jackson, was talking about Tupac, right? Mm-hmm. And so when you think about a lot of the great people that we call lyricists today, like Tupac, he was extremely well read, right?
Yeah.
Was a poet, knew how to write. You think about Nas, he's one of the great lyricists of our time. Nas was really well read, right?
Yeah.
Well studied, right? And so I think that we underestimate in hip hop the value of English and reading and writing and how it can do. And actually, when translate to media training, because you're actually conducting a really good interview. This is my first time meeting you.
Yeah.
So I know Rob, and so anybody Rob brings in, I'm like, well, she must be talented.
Yeah.
But you're selling yourself, right?
Thank you.
And even your word choice, your phrasing, like, you understand, like, sizable bites in terms of, like, how to talk in bite-sized sounds. Like, it's insane. I just hope everybody
Wynne
who's
been
listening.
Ready.
Yeah.
She's been ready for a minute.
Everybody who's listening is paying attention. If you are aspiring to be a rapper, like, especially think about getting our game artist, like, this is how you should be.
Yeah. That's how you present yourself.
Absolutely. To piggyback off of what Mike said, because we also had Keith Perrin here, one of the founders of FUBU, who said they did not have media training, they first started.
Yeah.
So you see, to Mike's point, what the difference was. As an artist, I know you hit those writer block days. It's days where no matter what, you throwing 50 things at the wall you can't get anything to stick.
Nah.
I always tell people who say they want to get in the game, and a blank piece of paper could be the scariest thing in the world. How do you write through it, fight through it, as much as you're willing to share?
I know Ty's over there laughing, because like I said, I'm a bull. Like, I'm something about me, like, I'm determined. So if I have writer's block, I'm not getting out of the room until I come up with something I like. So I will just sit there. It's maybe something I need to work on, because I'll sit there staring at my computer just pissed, like, just like, I'll try to write for an hour, and then once I haven't come up with anything in the hour, maybe I've written four bars that I don't even really like, at this point I'm sitting there and I'm like, damn, like, why is it not sticking today? And at the end of the day, it's like, it's not something you can force.
Yeah.
But boy, do I try to force it.
Yeah.
Like, I'm, because I hate leaving the studio feeling defeated. I hate leaving feeling like I didn't come with what I needed to leave with. So I'm gonna leave with it, no matter what it takes for me to get there. Like, if I gotta climb over a mountain, I'm gonna leave with it. But then we leave, and I'm like, okay, I did it. Like, that was good. Yeah.
I'm impressed with your focus.
Thank you.
Because when it comes to a lot of millennials and Gen Z, when we speak about our relationship with social media and us, you know, wanting instant gratification and not being able to, like, sit still for a while and get certain tasks done.
Yeah.
But it sounds like that's something you've been able to evade.
Yeah, I think, I mean, I obviously struggle with social media, as I think everybody does, but, like, this is really what I love to do. So when I'm sitting in front of my computer, like, I'm invested in what I'm doing. I'm trying to crack codes. Like it's really as much a, I was saying this earlier this week, like, it's as much a competitive sport to me as it is an art form. So when you put those things together, it's like a, you know, there's a lot of energy there. Yeah. I'm totally engulfed in the process.
Wynne is here, man. She got the new single, M Music Video, Ja Morant. You spell it WYNNE. How did you gain the Dreamville affiliation?
That's a great question. So back when I was in college at U of O, you know, my manager Court is from Atlanta and knows Barry and Zeke pretty well, Jid's team. And Jid was coming on tour through Eugene. He was playing Wow Hall. It was on it was like a year after the Never Story, I believe. And they were just like, yo, like, y'all need to link. Like, you guys just need to get together. I had Ego Check at the time, the record, and I had an open verse on it and knew I wanted him to.
Okay, so you already had the Ego Check.
I had the record, yeah, okay. and this was actually around the time the Eminem's daughter thing was going viral, and some people were like, yo, we should drop this record, and I was like, nah, I really feel like I need a feature on it, and we'd played around with it for a while, and I was just like, man, like, Jid would gas it, he would bring a different perspective, he would bring a different energy to it. I don't think people hear him on that kind of a beat very often. I think it'd be interesting. So I was lucky enough to link up with him when he was in Eugene, and I played him a couple records off the project, and there was another one on there he was interested in hopping on as well called, it's called Ken Mastro Giovanni, which is actually the name of my college drummer, my band, because he's a freak with it. But, you know, ultimately we talked about it, and Ego Check was the one, and he hopped on it and killed it, and it was a huge moment for me, for sure. I'm a big Jid fan.
I would imagine, too, because... being an artist, you do want a validation. You know, it feels good when someone recognizes you, right?
Totally.
You know, and unless you know you're walking up the right path. Mm-hmm. If they don't recognize you, you still got to have enough confidence in yourself, right?
Yeah.
You still got to do it. Who are some of those names? I know some big names that have recognized you, acknowledged some of the freestyles and stuff. Who are some of them?
Yeah, I mean, Snoop Dogg, Timbo.
Come on.
You know, Bia stays super tapped in.
Come on.
Meek Mill.
Come on.
Benny the Butcher. Man,
I think the biggest one,
top of my head, yeah,
Missy Elliott.
Yeah.
That's the one.
That, yeah, yeah, man. You know what's crazy is I actually predicted that.
Yeah.
I had dropped Buzzer, and it started to kind of go up on Twitter, and I saw someone retweeted it, and I clicked on their page, and they were followed by Missy Elliott. And at the time, I was like, I gotta go take a nap, like, I'm overwhelmed. And I was like, I bet Missy Elliott's gonna see it. And I went and took a nap, and Ty was out in the living room, we were crashing in Court's apartment, and I run out, and I'm like, crying, like, bro, Missy Elliott just retweeted my video. She told me to keep going, like, this is the craziest day of my life. Yeah, that was
that's
a while.
That's amazing.
So whenever you get any critique, which I'm sure you're going to get to. I'm sure you get critique, especially being a rapper, a white woman who's rapping. Remember those who boosted you.
Yeah.
For every person that critiqued you, for every million people that critiqued you, that's that 10 million people. It takes 10 million critiques to equate to a Missy Elliott validation.
That
you know?
Is,
so remember,
correct.
Remember that.
Good.
Okay?
Yes.
All right.
Absolutely.
Have you met any of the some of the stars of today, some of the female stars like Glorilla or...
You know, I haven't yet. It's
Lotto, none of those folks?
No, I've never met with them yet. I stay out in Portland. I don't travel very much. So, you know, I'm hopeful that over the coming year that some of those doors start to open for me, for sure.
You would love to rock with them.
I would love to rock with them. I'm a big Glo fan. I'm a big Lotto fan.
Uh-huh.
I'm a big Flo Milli fan. I'm a big Bia fan. I think there's so many of them that I would make really dope music with.
Not that it would seem an issue for you, but be open. You know, I think what happens is especially, you know, with female artists, you know, a lot of times, oh, she seemed like she had an attitude. Mm-hmm. Oh, we're competing. Oh, we're... It's none of that. Be open. Go over to sometimes, it may have to take you when to go over to someone in someone's camp and say, hi, I'm an artist. I would like to say hello.
Yeah.
I would like to meet, give a hug, make that exchange.
Yeah.
Even if it starts with you, that's okay. I think a lot of artists in the past have made that mistake by not being open first and thinking that it's a making this, because we do compete. It's a sport, right?
Yeah, totally.
But you put this thing in your head
where
you can't introduce yourself to folk. You can't do this. Can't do that. And I think, me personally, a lot more collaborations would have been done, especially in the 90s, if the mindset was different. So I would like to just share that with
you. Thank you.
Stay open.
I needed that from you. That was dope.
Stay open.
Got it from Heather B, you know.
A lot of mistakes was made. I'm just being honest. And it's okay to walk over to somebody and say hi.
And I'm a pretty shy person, so that's something I do struggle
just
with.
Just do it. Like, it'll somebody might remember that 5 years from now. You're like, you know what? I remember her. She was cool. She was nice. And it can, you know, just keep the bond.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Wynne, you're independent?
I am, yeah.
What's the affiliation to Rob Markman?
Man, I got a genius deal. I partnered with Genius on a distro tip.
Okay, congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
Wynne partnered up with Genius. Rob Markman doing a lot for Genius. They owe you more, Rob.
Yeah, he's an absolute legend.
They owe you. Who they?
Genius. They owe Rob Markman.
Yeah.
Genius owes Rob Markman. That's T-shirt. Who I'm saying. Case is not. Genius owes Rob Markman.
Speaking truth.
So, come on, man.
No more honesty. Truth.
If anybody from Genius wants to debate me on it, come on up.
Words.
Y'all know I know. And they know what I know.
Yes.
So Genius owes Rob Markman.
More.
Pay
period.
Rob more.
Yeah.
Give him more equity, more proprietorship into Genius.
Period. Yeah.
Come on, man. What did Rob, when you talked to Rob, where did y'all first meet?
We first met in, it was 2017 or 2018, I think. And I think it was 2018, we were playing him some music from the project.
Uh-huh.
And we went through the Genius office when it was still in New York and just kind of, you know, we hung out for about an hour, hour and a half and just had a conversation about music, inspiration. We played him through the mixtape and he was really rocking with it. And since then, he was supporting me. Genius had put me on the platform back when they were doing Cosign. They put me on the Twista episode and Twista rocked with it. So Twista's another one.
Uh-huh.
So they've always been super supportive. And Rob first reached out to me about a year ago and was like, yo, just want to put this on your radar. Like, I think we're going to start doing some distro stuff. And like, you're definitely one of the artists I would want to work with. So it couldn't have been more perfect timing for me. I mean, I grew up on Rap Genius. Like when it was all highlighted in red, I was like annotating Lupe lyrics in my bedroom. So it's a dream for sure.
It's a dream come
where
true.
Where Genius at? She said when they was in New York. Where you at, Rob?
I'm still in New York, but the company's in LA.
Now. Oh, okay.
Yeah, they went to move to Hollywood.
Give them more. I see what you're saying now,
all
Sway.
The way in, yeah,
that's
man.
Why
well,
that's why I ain't moved to LA.
Okay.
Okay. Well, Wynne, it's a real pleasure to have you on this show.
Yeah.
We're really big
Can't
fans of yours,
man.
Congratulations, because you did
Thank
the work,
you.
Too. You've been doing
you
your
did.
Work, man.
And
Thank
Wynne,
you.
And I know that last night was hard for you.
Mm.
I know it was probably hard to really settle your mind down and relax it.
Yeah.
I know it was hard. All kind of thoughts was running through your head because you're here in New York City. That's a long way from Portland,
it's
Oregon.
A long way.
Oh, that's a lot of redwood trees where you're from. A lot of clean air, right?
Clean air,
man. And
dirty air here.
It was important that you got your rest.
Yeah.
It was important that you got your rest because you had to get up this morning. And where were you coming? Where did you know you was going this morning?
I know I was coming to Sway in the fucking morning.
To the Valley of the Hyenas! Drop that beat on her!
Let's go.
Portland, stand up. We got Wynne up in here. Sway in the morning, turn that beat up, Torch.
Woo!
Come on.
Yeah, crank that beat a little bit.
Yeah.
Crazy beat, man. Shout out to
Hyenas only, Portland. It's time we up.
Most of y'all couldn't touch this beat with a 10-foot pole. I went in cold, no stretching. I just set into crescendo flows. It's people who bet against me about to end up broke. The standards and the bars, 10 years I've been benching them both. Mental and coke, tension just bubbling at the surface. They're showing their friends my shit like, how the fuck you haven't heard this? cocky men think they could fuck me, just know you're wrong. The insecure men say I'm selling my body to sell these songs. Y'all should lose your virginity, dissatisfied tendencies. Stay out my business, lest you put in money towards my entities. Fucked up at the party, they don't know I heard them mention me. Hoping I blow up first, cause they secretly all depend on me. Healthy competition on my beat, free range. You're not for the culture, Petrie, you just retweet things. But you don't mean those things, you just dying for interaction. You scared to look in the mirror like, damn, what happened? Windex, I'm on a streak, can't rest, I'm on my feet. Won't catch me slipping through the cracks like keys between the Honda seats. Met with a couple labels who act like I was average. Like it's fourth and one, I just wonder how you could pass this. I'm like Victor Wembanyama. Please don't switch, cause I'll pick up on you. The triple threat kinesthetics put him on ice like Arnold Palmer. They yell over the vocals, I'm not talking DJ drama. Proofreading the checks, they write me like, this needs some commas. They thought all they needed was a Spotify playlist. Jogging by the competition, singing Marvin Gaye hits. Like, what's going on? I thought y'all were so confident. Here I am up in the gym at 6 a.m. back on my Mamba shit. Cosmo and Wanda, they keep wishing that they were topping this. Like Obi, I'm the one like Kenobi, I've found my confidence. Keep my IG sexy, cause I know your boyfriend's stocking it. They're studying my shine, made my haters meteorologists. Elbows on their knees, I watch them bury their face. Every single rapper should be very afraid. I really got your favorite artist out here sharing my page. Here to fuck up the throne like Harry and Meghan's engaged. I'm in an esoteric state, this shit's never been a joke. I was 9, staying up till 2 a.m. studying hove. Lord knows, while y'all were outside just doing the most, I was dirty and every beat that they give me is getting gross. Don't envy industry circles, they're really jerking off. I'm here showing the sheep where to go like a herding dog. Snakes in the grass, I hear rodents scurrying off. I'm mowing the lawn, walking with cleats to make sure they're gone. I've been that bitch, how I do it is magic. Foolish to try to prove it, so screw all the acrobatics. Got close to the gold and I noticed that it was plastic, so I don't do it for that shit. The truth is this shit my passion. Just know when you say my name, you don't pronounce the E. Count up all my clones and they still don't amount to me. I'm the quietest in the room and still no one as loud as me. Still in Portland, if you need me, I'm just down the street. Count the beat, 1, 2, 3, 4. By the time you hear this, I have my old bullies at my door. Like, damn, I knew you could do it. They're trying to build rapport. I'm in their head, not paying rent and rearranging the decor. Fuck them.
You notice she gave a reference to who the Spurs got.
Victor. Man, I thought we were going to get him in Portland.
Yeah, man.
I know. We were this close.
I didn't hear that. Wow.
You heard it, Sway. You heard it.
Wow. I didn't hear that. Keep the applause going, Torch. Keep the applause going.
Kilt.
Keep them going. Keep them going.
Wow. It takes work. It's work. You might luck up one or two freestyles, little viral moments, but it takes a lot of work to get to this point and to be. You got it's showmanship, it's delivery, it's breath control, it's bars, it's all of the things. And she exemplified it, man. You got to give credit where credit
there
is due.
Is.
Like Missy said, keep going, sis.
Keep
you got
going.
It.
Keep flowing, Wynne.
You got it,
what?
Man.
Don't pronounce
Thank
the
you,
E.
Don't pronounce the E.
Damn bullies showing up trying to gain a rapport. The bullies trying to gain a rapport.
They're already showing up.
Already showing up.
Last night on my FaceTime.
That just happened? Really?
Yes. What?
People who used to bully.
I'm telling you, I have sitting there with them on the phone practicing my verse and I'm like, look at this. I just manifested this before it's even out.
People who used to bully you are now calling you.
Oh, yeah.
Forgive them.
Wow.
Show them grace. Forgive them.
I got to.
Yeah, forgive them. Welcome them
forgive
in.
Forgive and let go.
Yeah. Forgive and let go and move
Absolutely.
Forward, okay?
Absolutely.
Give it up for Wynne, y'all. She's a star.